Just looking at the design of these temples, they had what's known as molten. I think that's what happens to metal when it's melted. And then they had the temple of Zerubbabel. And let the house be builded in Ezra, the place where they offered sacrifices, and let the foundations thereof be strongly laid in a height thereof 60 cubits. Now, it was the lavish display of the precious metals, the elaboration. And they built one of these temples of Herod. The great announced the people assembled at Passover BC 20 or 19. His intention of restoring the temple. Oh. Now, a lot of people have been building temples to themselves. Seems like we spent about $1 trillion building Homeland Security fusion centers. Could you get me the actual location of those? And then I know Homeland Security is the security of the United States of America, and their concern was making sure that they have places to put people, the ICE detention centers. And I was watching the news, and it's nice that we cleaned out that little prison camp that you had there in Mexico or Arizona, or where the fuck it was. Pooch. But my thought was, you're really just waiting for the $192 million facility to be built so that you can house those that have been trying to sneak into the United States. You know, cause and effect. Thunder and lightning, or is it lightning first and then thunder? Pooch! Why don't we look at the budget of Homeland Security and what they really budgeted? Yes. To be able to spend, to have the right facilities to house those individuals that are the illegal aliens of the United States. Now, I know some of these third world nations, it's their fault that they keep walking this direction. Yes, they probably have some water needs too. I mean, let's think about the nation of Mexico. Could you call the president of Mexico for me? Poop. You know, I had wanted to do some business with Mexico, and closing that border would somewhat hinder the actual business interests of both the United States and Mexico. Now, I'm not trying to tell the president how to do his job. Just shutting down the border because of these illegal individuals that keep trying to walk in here. But let's say Mexico wanted to buy some of these water tanks. It's one of these hotter nations of the wild. Why don't you get me the water supply of Mexico and ask them, yes, would you like to buy some recycled garbage water storage tanks that can be used during drought or low pressurization of the water supply of the Mexican people, of the Mexican nation? Yes. While at the same time using it when it is raining so as to clean out the sewers. Now, a lot of this shit that you have in Mexico, yes, I'd like to do some business with you. See, Mexico, on the left side of it, yes, if you're looking down, yes, it has an ocean next to it. And on the right side, there's another ocean on the other side called the Pacific. Yes, I thought I'd put some desalinators in Mexico and have it rain in the desert. Complete waste of water, really. But this whole thought that we're going to completely eradicate all commerce between the United States and Mexico because of a few thousand individuals that think they can just walk the fuck in here right now causes me some concern, because what am I going to do as a business owner when I'm trying to ship my products from here down to there? Now, I know you would not think that probably a $10 to $15 million problem would cause billions upon billions of dollars of problems for those nations that are south of the United States. Yes, because I'm sure the president of the United States considered the economic effect of all his decisions. But my thought is, well, why don't we take the aid away from the poorest nations of the world because of a few bad apples, pooch, that keep walking this direction? Think if they could get to the United States, their life would be better. Now, there could be this problem of how foreign aid is being spent. Let's say I talked to some of these foreign nations that receive the foreign aid, and I said, well, I will give you the money if you buy my products. Sounds kind of mean, okay? Fresh water in Guatemala, El Salvador. I mean, what would want a person to leave one of these poor nations and move all the way up here, walking 10,000 miles to get here, that thinks that, well, we'll just walk in the United States, they'll let us in. As soon as we touch the soil of the United States, they're obligated to listen to us as refugees. Now the thought is maybe it's being the aid is being spent in the wrong way. Now I know as the United States of America, closing the border down for all of those that do business might be a bigger problem than the actual illegals that keep trying to get in here. Now oh, is that right, Border Patrol? Why don't you give me the stupid fucks right now? I think this is just a wonderful idea that we'll put on the news, those in barbed wire fences, so as to justify the budget of the Homeland motherfucking security right now. You idiot.